Good day, fellow investors. Now we start to dig into the interesting silver investments, Taho Resources, which shows exactly why investing in miners is extremely risky. Taho Resources stock price went from 26 above 26 in 2014, dropped to below 10, went up to 15 in 2016, and now we are at 4.68. The reason for such a drop is the largest silver mine in the world, Escobal, has lost its license to operate in Guatemala because of environmental issues. We'll talk a bit more about that later. So they have this big mine in Guatemala, and locals, environmentalists, are not that happy about the mine, so they have suspended it. They have managed the government court of Guatemala to suspend the mine. When that happens, Taho is really, really hit. And now from an investment perspective, we have to see, okay, what's Taho worth without that? Let's say it's impaired completely. Are the other parts of Taho worth this price that make this investment a low risk, high return bet if the Escobal mine gets back its license? Let's dig more into that. So Taho's profitability, Q1 was very good, Q2 was okay, and then since the suspension of the mine, it went into negative territory. Nevertheless, it was still profitable for 2017. They are investing a lot in growth expansion projects, so it might lower the importance of Escobal. There is also liquidity, but we don't know if this 175 million liquidity credit will hit the debt covenants on the EBITDA without Escobal. That's always a risk and something to look into more depth. Nevertheless, the gold production and expected gold productions is growing. They expect to hit 500 plus 550 plus 1,000 ounces in the future, which is very interesting. If that will be a future growth production. Plus, there is always the Escobal option. Let's see what happened to Escobal. In the summer, their license was revoked or temporarily suspended. The Supreme Court issued the ruling that reinstated the Escobal mine. However, that was appealed to the higher constitutional court, so we are still waiting for a ruling. The company remains optimistic about the ruling, so they think they will get the license near term. However, there are also roadblocks at the mine which are not allowing diesel, not allowing power, not allowing everything to come to the mine, which means that the mine isn't possible to operate even if they get the license. So that's something, if you want to see the optionality of Escobal, you should really dig into the Guatemalan news and see whether Taho might win or not. Let's say I'm interested in Taho. What do I do? I dig into each miner, each mine, each operational part, see what's the value, see what's the value if Taho owns it or if somebody else owns it, see what's the optionality if on Escobal. As I said, I don't want risk, but I want huge upside. So even if Escobal gets lost, if I don't lose money, it might be an interesting investment. So what is necessary here, I didn't find it anywhere online, is to make an in-depth analysis, really cash flows, everything, risks, mine by mine that Taho owns, to see what it will end up with and what's the actual fair value now with or without Escobal. Preliminary research, I have found this. Escobal is not Taho's only problem. Let's see. La Arena mine in Peru is in the same situation. Or the management of Taho doesn't see that they have to think about the environment and they are protesting there and they have managed to stop Newmont from building a mine, maybe they will manage to stop Taho from building also this mine. So, or the management doesn't see what's going on, or they think they will get along very well, independent of the local protests. What I will do, I have on my list, I will research Taho in depth. I have to sit down and then really see, okay, now we are at an interesting price, really see what's the risk reward. Perhaps it will be a dud, perhaps it will be a great investment. I think we are hitting closely to 10,000 subscribers, so as a gift, I will do the Taho in detail research analysis, risk reward, to see whether it is a good analysis or not. This is just a preliminary research. If you have more info on that, please share it in the comments. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.